What's going on, PincheAls fans? Thanks for tuning in to this episode of PincheAls Garage. Now, this one, we're going back a few months, back in September, where I flew out to Tennessee to help out a fellow subscriber. Yes, that's what I do. I help out the community, and I help out as much as I can. So, we're here in Tennessee, beautiful state, by the way. We're out here to help out a friend by the name of Dan. And this guy had a car that has not been running for years, and he just couldn't find the time or just been able to get it up and running. He hit me up, flew me out, and we decided to build a car in 3 days. Now, just keep in mind, on the third day, I did fall down and busted my arm. If you guys remember that, I was in the hospital, and that was 3 months ago. So I'm here to tell the tale, and so hopefully you guys join me and enjoy the video here. All right, so let's get to work, because this is PincheAls Garage.
Good morning, everybody. Nice and early here in Tennessee. That's right, Tennessee. Out here in the backwoods. It's pretty cool. It's gorgeous over here. It's almost 9 in the morning. Woke up at 8. Something, well, technically I woke up at 6:30, 7-ish. And it's almost 8 o'clock. 9 o'clock. Went a little overboard yesterday and working on stuff. But we finally got the mock-up on the entire turbo setup. So my goal today now, when we start working on this big turbo Mark IV, is to... Oh.
So at this point, this was day two. I did not film day one, where we just pulled the motor out. Pretty much the entire night, we pulled the motor out of the engine bay. And then we had to figure out a jerry rig, pulling the engine out of the trunk, because his fully built motor was in the trunk of the GTI, and there was no space to like put a cherry picker and lift it. So we had to like jerry rig a full like lift system to get it out of the out of the trunk of this car. It was fun. It was a fun day with Dan, and it was just like one little hiccup after the other. Just keep in mind, we're going from a 5-speed to a 6-speed, and when you go from 5-speed to 6-speed on a Mark IV, there's a couple little things that you have to understand. The heat shield's not the same. Obviously, the clutch and flywheel system are not the same. There's a lot of things that are just not the same. So you guys have to understand, when you start going into one setup to another, you're going to realize really quick that some things are not going to be as easy to convert. However, he had almost all the parts that we needed. Obviously, the clutch, the master cylinder, the slave cylinder, all the things that needed to make the conversion proper. Now, this is actually a DIY that I will be making down the road, converting from a 5-speed to a 6-speed manual transmission. It's not as easy as most people think it is. Don't worry. PincheAls here. We're going to make a DIY for that. On top of that, we actually have a new DIY coming as well. Stay tuned for that, on converting an automatic to a manual. It is a big job. A lot of people ask me for it. I'm going to fulfill your guys' dreams and doing and learn how to do a swap like that. But be forewarned ahead of time, it is a pain in the B-O-O-T-Y. All right? Booty.
Is to get it in the car. So we had to do some grinding and some stuff, because we put a... Mark IV 6-speed transmission on here, and things are different, so we have to modify some stuff. So we'll give you guys a rundown on exactly what we did. There's Mr. Dan.
Morning, guys.
A little camera shy. So we have to break down on exactly what we did, so you guys can see. You know, it's a big turbo. It's not hard to do what we did. It's not like anything different that we've done on this channel. So we missed some parts, not no big deal. We ordered them. Cool thing, AutoZone out here, they still got VW parts. However, they ain't got no VWs out here. Yeah. Oh man. You know, Chevy and Ford out here is like, wow. You know, and then you look for a VW. I saw one VW in town, and there's nothing left. So we're gonna show you guys how beautiful this engine is. All right, now here it is, fully built 118.
This bad baby right here, she's making over 1,700 horsepower.
Yep. Look at that Turbski right there. There's more downpipe than there is turbo.
This is my big turbo. It's the KO3S.
Nah, we're just kidding. Not even a KO3. There is the turbo, there's the motor that we put together yesterday. So, it's got the Grams intake manifold, stock throttle body, swirl pop mounted on the side. There's, ooh la la, GT30 right there.
GTX 3076R.
Yep, GTX 3070X or whatever R. I'm tired. I just woke up. So, full on V-Ben, stainless steel exhaust. We got the oil lines and the coolant lines all ran the way that I think it should be running for how comfortable I want it to be from what I'm looking at. Our biggest problem on this setup currently right now is the exhaust manifold. So, not meaning it's a problem, meaning it's we don't have the nuts for it to mount it correctly. So, we're going to figure that out when we get to that point. Because I have to show Dan how to install it correctly so he doesn't risk on damaging the exhaust and all that. But she came out really, really nice. We had a tinker with a lot of stuff on here, but I think we got it. We got the 6-speed transmission on here. We got the FX400 Clutch Masters clutch on this. Very, very nice clutch. 6-puck. He wanted it matte black, so we painted it matte black. So we have a nice, really dark black paint job on this. We just ordered the gasket for the housing right here, the oil filter housing. So that just came in. We got to go pick that up. We got the gasket for the exhaust manifold. We had to get a throwout bearing for the transmission because this is a 6-speed, so it's a hydraulic throwout bearing. And then we had to go grab that. So yeah, there's a lot to go on here. So we got to get into the truck and we're going to head out and we're going to show you guys, you know, what we're going to be doing next. Peace out, peeps.
All right. So now this is the part of the video where we're just busting butt, going as fast as we can to get this video, get the engine taken care of. We're doing our mock-ups. We're doing our maintenance. We're making sure, double checking fittings, double checking everything that's going on in this engine. We have to make sure everything fits because I'm leaving the next day technically. So there's a day that's missing on this video, just FYI. I'll explain later when we get to that point. But again, we're missing a day. We're mocking up, making things work. The engine's looking great. Everything's fitting the way it's supposed to fit. AutoZone's getting us parts as fast as we can get them. I mean, everything's working out for Dan, and I'm super happy and very proud of him as well because he's mechanically inclined to get involved and get things done. So check it out. So what you see going on here is we're finishing up the mock-up. And then Sam's mom comes by, not Dan's, but Sam's mom comes by. Just meet and greet, you know, we're just talking and, you know, shooting the shit and just saying what's up. Sam's bike had to be left behind that day. He had a motorcycle and kind of broke down or something happened. I can't remember. Oh, it was a flat. So they had to move the bike and put it on the trailer. And then pretty much after that, this is the engine. This is what it came out to be. Gorgeous, gorgeous engine. I mean, we were done. We were ready to get this bad boy in the next day. So that's what we ended up doing. Lots of work, lots of love, and this is the end result. Beautiful, beautiful engine.
Yes, that is accurate. All right, so we are back, and we're ready to go. So what we're going to do is I'm going to hold down the plunger for the slave cylinder. And yesterday, it went all the way down and stayed down, right?
Right.
Let's do that. Let it sit down on the bottom. We don't have to worry about pumping the clutch. So first, I'm going to hold the cylinder. So give me a second here. Okay, now put the pedal to the ground, nice and slow. Okay, that's all I needed to do. Okay, now this is its very first startup.
So this is the moment where you see me walk into frame and you see the evidence of the broken wrist. This is the day after I broke my wrist. They pulled my arm apart to set the bones, and I'm going to be going to surgery the next day. So we're getting ready to get Dan's car up and running because I'm getting ready to leave. I'm going to have surgery, then I got to go home. But I got to stay in Tennessee for a few.
All we wanted to do is run and then turn it off, okay? We don't need the wipers going, though.
I know. I don't know why I'm doing that.
Don't worry about it right now. Just fire it up. All right. Yeah. So right now, I think you have a. Hold on. Let me see. You probably have them on. Yeah, they're on, dude. Right now we don't have the relay on, so all we're doing is priming, okay? We're just priming the motor right now. So you're gonna crank it for 5 seconds and stop. And then wait 10 seconds, crank it for 5 seconds and stop. We gotta put oil and stuff, so go. All right, stop, hold on. Woo, it's cranking. It is cranking, I just saw the oil cap bounce around. So we got compression. All right, do it again. Good. Wait like 10, 15 seconds and then do it again. We gotta hurry because we're almost out of time. We got 3 minutes to get this going. So go. That's a good battery. This is cranking quick, man. All right, again. You have any more rubber caps?
What size?
Doesn't matter, just rubber caps. We need to cap off these three things. Yeah, because we're going to have a shit ton of vacuum right here. If we don't fix this, it won't fire. It'll fire, but it'll be like really bad. By the way, guys, you don't need intercooler piping. It won't. It'll just run like a 1.8, just NA. It's just we need to cap this side because anything after the throttle body is vacuum. Anything before the throttle body is just boost, so it's not going to care for that. Just a quick pointer for that. How'd you find the other one that you had yesterday?
I don't know. Everything was moving around.
Well, I think I'd be able to. Yeah, I can cap them with my finger. We're good. I can cap them. All right, do one more crank and then pop in the relay. Yep. That's it. Pop in the relay. Take the key out. Take the key all the way out.
It's on top. On top. On top. There you go.
So it's the one. It only goes into one spot. Should be on the far right, I believe. And the relay only goes in one way, so. Officially 2:30. I'll make it over here, don't worry.
I can't see shit with your glasses.
It's like next to the really big relay. Put the key in the on position.
Key in off position?
On.
On position.
You should hear the fuel pump prime. I didn't hear it.
Yeah.
Alright, we'll see if what happens. Let's give it a try. One more time. There's no gas. Just got in the wrong spot, that's all. Hold on. No, I smell gas. I'm smelling gas.
Started as well.
I already bolted it down.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. Trying to think here. Go for it. Do it again. Yeah, there's definitely gas coming in. So. We might have to check spark. So let's go, come back, and then
okay.
Do a final test.
Yep.
Because we might have to, because some working. All right, everybody, we're back. So we found out the fuel pump has officially failed on here. Good thing that Dan bought a brand new fuel pump prior to this, so we're good. So we're going to actually fire it up finally. So let's get to work. Let's see if she fires up.
Ready?
You got the. Yeah, go for it. Let go, let go, let go. We got the fuel pump relay in there? We do, right? Yeah, I think we do.
We do.
Yeah. Okay, I'm trying to think what else we need to worry about. Okay, give it another shot. Yeah, let it. Don't try to keep cranking it. Don't do that. It's firing. So.
All right.
Ready? One.
Remember, don't step on the clutch or the brake. Once it gives a little bit of gas, once it starts firing, give it a little, like, give it very, like, a pinch of gas. Don't floor it. Okay?
Right.
Go. It runs.
It runs.
We got it running.
Oh yeah, man.
Told ya.
It fucking mastered. It worked.
It runs, but I mean, obviously it's gonna run like shit because it's missing everything else.
Yeah, I mean, obviously she's got no piping or nothing, but.
Yeah. No, but it runs.
Oh boy, oh boy.
Yeah, let's so see, nice, see if we can do one more thing. Let me get to run a little bit better.
That thing doesn't really even want to thread in there.
No, that doesn't, don't thread it all. Again.
Again.
Hold on. Battery might want to fall. Alright, give me a second here. Go for it. Now, at this point, we officially got the car running. 3 days of back-breaking work, nonstop, every single day, bright and early, wrenching on this car, making sure everything fits, everything is in the right order. I made sure that Dan walked away with minimal work effort or work required to get this car done. So Dan was stoked because you guys got to keep in mind, this car has been sitting for years. It was a car that he was going to give up officially. Not because he didn't have the time or he didn't have the know-how. It's just the ability to want to do it. You guys got to understand, when you build a car or a project, you start wrenching on it and then life comes into play. Once life takes over, sometimes you lose the urge to do your, and you need that kick in the ass or in the butt, whatever you want to call to get going. And he calling me, and I accept to see him and get his motivation back. From day started wrenching, he got excited for his build. He got work. Dan, he's been quality stuff. The arrears legit. Stuff that's gonna last car brand. I mean, and it worked out in this. Preview AC trip, but the accident with wrist break kind of got me a little down the dumps because it's pretty depressing. You don't get me wrong. You're out to break your was. It's up and running. Be